The Echo project is about bringing the resources and knowledge about immersive recording techniques into the public. We aim to release the open access database of high quality orchestral recordings made using 7 different microphone arrays designed by expert group of engineers. We want to bridge the gap between the industry and academia. People can actually listen to the recordings and compare all different microphone arrays themselves, not just, you know, learn about theories. And it's not about finding which technique wins over other techniques. It's about you know, understanding the differences and finding the relative merits. You can actually not just compare different techniques, but you can combine different microphones from different arrays and they kind of, you know, create your own sort of preferred configuration. But the most important thing is that you get inspired into a world of immersive audio through this project.
Okay. Yeah, we'll aim to be tighter.
My name's Nick Wollage. I'm a recording engineer and mixing engineer. My role in this project is co-organizer with Katia and Hyunkook. I'm also one of the focus group engineers as well. This idea was born out of a very lively and slightly frustrated conversation between the three of us, Katia, Hyunkook and myself, in a pub in Halifax. And we were enthusing about the potential of being able to combine the worlds of academic research and studio practice. What a great opportunity it would be if we could put all of these people in the same room at the same time, experimenting, practicing, demonstrating their methodology, learning from each other.
Echo Project was an idea born out of passion, collectively of people coming together and realizing we are all very curious about spatial audio. And we have lots of questions and we love experimenting. We hope to achieve a few things, really. I'm coming from a mixed background, like research and music production, and I'm particularly interested in that initial stage of music composition, of perception, of spatial audio, and the limitations of our auditory system.
Air Studios historically has a strong history of experimentation. It was born out of a sense of innovation, because George Martin, who was the founder and very much the figurehead of this company, the artists that he was working with at that time in the 60s were very much pushing the boundaries of experimentation with the medium at the time. And I knew when we needed somewhere to record, to host our ideas, that this would be the place. Really, it has the acoustic credentials, but it also has the sort of spirit that we were looking for. So it embodies our idea, really. So when we decided that we wanted an extra listening room, because we wanted to host this event in one of the studios, and there's already a control room obviously, but we wanted a separate room for the 714 monitoring, there was only one option for us to call upon for assistance, so we called Dynaudio.
So with all those stages of music production and composition, we want to touch base on how to compose for immersive format, how to record for immersive format, how to produce for spatial.
I'm Anthony Caruso. I am principal audio engineer at Sony PlayStation, and I work with the music team there. It's in a creative arts team. So my role here is to bring some experience working with PlayStation games, which is a very immersive environment, and a lot of recording that we've done here at Air, doing orchestra, and kind of, you know, collaborating with the other people here on experiences that we've had and ideas that we've had. Our expectations coming out of this will be to add in some of the things we've learned from, you know, the great people that we're working with and collaborating with here. Being able to experiment in a way like this is pretty unprecedented and uncommon, so it's a very special experience. I'm sure anything that we learn will be an amazing thing.
We have 96 microphones, and there's actually more than 96, actually. And, you know, by listening to each array, you can learn what kind of sonic benefits you can get from different arrays, but they can actually listen to the recordings and compare all different microphone arrays themselves. It's not just reading papers.
So we feel very, very strongly about that free resource and having this incredible opportunity to record at air and with the best musicians in the world, with amazing composer, with amazing conductor, amazing music producers, best sound engineers, to create this incredible resource for free is what really, really resonates with us, and we want to share that with everyone.